reluctantly crouched at the starting line. Engines pumping and thumping in time. The green light flashes, the flags go up. Churning and burning, they yearn for the cup. They deftly maneuver and muscle for rank. Fuel burning fast on an empty tank. Reckless and wild, they pour through the turns. Their prowess is potent and secretly stern. As they speed through the finish, the flags go down. The fans get up and they get out of...
Hey, good morning, everybody. Thanks for joining us back out of the range. We're testing a few more suppressors today with our special guest, Carmen, here. So as far as the test guns go, we have our Colt 14.5 machine gun with our 11.5 upper and a 14.5 BCM pin and weld. What's on the end of those guns, Carmen?
I think you should be able. We got some Griffin taper mounts on the end, and then we have also some rugged flashlighters that we're going to be running the hands on.
Cans that we're shooting today is the Rugged Razor 556. This is going to be our test can, just a can that we shoot every video so that you can see what this sounds like in comparison to the new suppressors that we're shooting. And then the two cans that we're shooting today are going to be the AB Warthog 556 and the Polonium 556. They're both sub $500 suppressors, and we're kind of just going to battle them out and see which one comes out on top.
Sweet. For ammo today, we're using kind of our control ammo here, some Winchester M193, it's 55 grain stuff, so kind of keeping some familiarity there.
Cool.
Let's get after it.
Let's do it.
14.5 BCM, this is my personal gun, pre-2008, I've had this gun for a long time, so pin and welded, and let's see what we got. One of my favorites. The tone's really good. The gas is probably a 3.5 on this. It's pleasant. Oh, I like it. It's a good lightweight.
Hey guys, so first up we have the AB Warthog 556 on the Colt 14.5. I just want to let you know that we are not actually terrible shots. We are intentionally shooting a steel every once in a while just so that you can hear what it sounds like when the round hits the steel in comparison to the shot when it just goes into the dirt, right? Little bit gassy on the 14.5. I put that at about a 6 for me. I don't know what Andy's scale is. Sounds really good on the receiving end of the gun, but you know, behind the gun it is a little bit louder than some of the others. It's not really meant to be. So let's see what that Polonium sounds like in comparison.
Hey everyone, so I got the Colt 14.5 and we're going to be shooting the Otter Creek Polonium. I've been really wanting to shoot this and I'm really excited to see what it sounds like. So let's give her a whirl. On a gas scale for me, the last one was a 6. You know, I'd probably stay around the 7, 6, 7 also. Still a little gassy, but nothing crazy. So I liked it, it's good stuff.
Next up, we have the AB Warthog 556 on the 11.5 Colt.
Tight.
this is probably my favorite can on an SBR. Gas stays about the same, right around that 5-6 range, even on, you know, the shorter guns, which is kind of hard to do. And I think it's one of the better sounding 5.56 cans on the short barrels. Thoroughly enjoy this one.
Okay, we got the Polonium Otter Creek again, but we're on the Colt with the 11.5 barrel this time. So let's check her out on something a little shorter. This on the shorter barrel. I do think the AB has kind of a lower tone to it than this Otter Creek, but I think that this Otter Creek still sounds really good. It is a little sharper. I feel like it was less gassy on the shorter. Maybe I'm just crazy. Probably am. But I put it maybe at like a 5 or, yeah, like a 5 for the gassiness on this one. But I honestly really like this can. I'm a fan of it. I think the AB does have some better points to it in some things, but she ain't too bad, so yeah.
I'm loading mags, so I get the mag dump.
Mag dump.
See how she does in full auto. Ronald Reagan, not a sponsor. Pretty good tone. Hard to notice a gas when there's a lot of other things going on. But I think the tone on the shooter's ear is really nice. It's got a good deep tone. How'd it sound from over there?
Good.
Really good.
Yeah?
Good.
Yeah, no, it was pleasant. I will say I shoot a lot of like dedicated 5.56 suppressors, and this was a lot less back pressure than the ones that I own personally. So yeah, I really dig it. And I think, I don't know if we touched on this earlier, but I actually like the way it looks. Like it, I know it sounds silly, but like, it looks like a suppressor that would be in a movie, just because it's such a simple design. It's not trying to do anything super fancy, but yeah, overall pretty sweet. Sam's full auto gas meter, that was honestly like a 5. It was pleasant. I didn't shoot it in semi-auto, but it's not what this test is for.
So, all the way forward.
Okay.
Widen your stance a little bit more.
Okay.
Lean into it, stiffen up your back, like lower back right here.
Okay.
Lean into it. Pull more with this arm than you do this one. Pull a lot with this one into your shoulder.
Okay.
And then you're leaning forward a little bit more, because if you're standing like you normally do, like this, you're gonna go like that.
Okay.
So, widen your stance, really bend that front knee.
Okay.
Lean into it and just get in there and dig. All right.
Get on in there, brother. Okay, so we got the Colt 11.5 again, but we got the AB Warthog. We gonna be doing that full auto stuff, so let's go, brother. Okay, Cam, I gotta fully get in here. Okay, I'm a little nervous. Right, Dong? Bend them? Like that? Thank you. A wee bit fun. She's gassy though. She was gassy compared to that Otter Creek. I feel like obviously I didn't shoot it, but that AB was kind of gassy on my scale. It's like a 7-8, maybe 8 is probably too high. She was fun though.
All right, my turn. Full auto AB Warthog 11.5. Gas really isn't terrible. Full auto is definitely a little bit worse. I'd put that at like a 6. It's not a barrel. Still not terrible. And I really like the tone of the AB. All right, next up, full auto dump. Colt 11.5 Otter Creek, because we're in North Idaho. Polonium 5.56. It's a little bit more gassy than the AB, not much. I like a 6.5.
Because it's getting around your iPro.
Yeah, the iPro. Yeah. Still sounds really good though. definitely comparable for on the cheaper side. It's one of the better sounding 5.56 cans.
So we're going to be testing the Razor on the BCM 14.5 next, you know, as our control next to the
Otter Creek 5.56 on the Colt 14.5.
Otter Creek.
Creek.
Yeah, this rugged's louder.
Yeah.
By a lot.
For sure.
Flashier too.
Is it flashier?
A little flashier from the side, yes.
I will say, I don't know if it's the mount back here, but I'm getting a lot more gas back in my face compared to the 14.5 with that can.
This is a shorter gas length too. I feel like there would be more.
Either way, still better than the next bay over.
Yeah. Suppress your guns, kids.
Medic!
What happened?
We lost a good man today.
Over.
I like, well, did you stop it?
Can we just acknowledge rap?
Spoon man.
Support, please, sir.
Expectations versus reality. I'm very enthusiastic about that Otter Creek. It sounds really good. The gas was really good on it. Tone from the sides, I think, was acceptable for what it is. I don't think the flash, actually the flash was slightly better than the rugged, and I've shot that rugged a long time, so.
That's probably why it was better. You've been shooting the rugged a long time. It's a little old.
It is a
baffle design.
I don't know how old it is, and that's a good point. Rugged may have made some interior changes over the last 10 years. That can's really old. So that Razor's got some mileage on it, so I don't know if the current generation may be slightly different. So, but again, that's our baseline can, and that's my baseline rifle. So what do you think about the Polonium?
Well, I was super excited to get it. I kept seeing them come through, so I kept asking Andy to get one through, and he gave me some backlash, but finally we got it, and I'm really impressed by it. I really like it. I do think there are, you know, some better options, but for the price and stuff, I think the Otter Creek Polonium did really good and exceeded expectations.
I was definitely a culprit of Andy giving backlash towards it. I was reading some numbers on it, and it did not look good in comparison to the AB, which is a little bit cheaper. We'll talk about that one later. But I was impressed. For what it is, I'm impressed.
Mm-hmm. I don't think you're going to go wrong with either of the two units. You know, they're both hub back. The weight's very similar. Size is very similar on both of those. I think if you're shooting...
Get some.
I think if you're shooting a 10, an 11, and a 13 inch, I think these are both going to be really well suited for you. You know, they both have a gas mitigation or gas control feature. So they're not marketing as that.
Yeah.
It's an excellent price point on both of these units.
Yeah.
I don't have anything really negative to say. We're going to cover barrel length restrictions and stuff, which I think they're both pretty much wide open cans. They are on the heavier side out of Inconel or Stellite, but that's just what they are. So I don't think they're unwieldy or overly heavy though on these. So.
No, not at all.
No.
There's a lot heavier product out there that performs a lot worse. So.
We'll talk about specs here in a minute.
Yep. So. Yeah. Hey, welcome back to the shop. Hopefully you liked the video we put out. We're just gonna go over a little bit of the specs this morning on the Otter Creek Polonium. So this is a 17-4 stainless suppressor, H900 heat treat. It has a minimum barrel length restriction on a 7.5-inch 5.56, so most of you guys out there will be okay. The folding PDW AR guys, just be careful on this when you're running it. Other than that.
We really appreciate you guys coming along this journey with us, figuring out this can and seeing what it's like. Just like, subscribe, hit the bell in the corner, you know, get the notifications. Stay tuned for next Friday when we post our next video. So have a good day.
Thanks, guys.
Bye.